And we would just like to wish everyone from the EBC Canada Bureau
happy 104th anniversary and 50 years anniversary here in the West for your church mission in the West.
And now we are live here at the CAA Center with Brother Falmar Sereno, who is a minister of the gospel here in Canada. So Brother Falmar, we can witness the celebration today, and it's truly grand. It's great energy here at CAA Center. And you being a pioneer of Canada, how would you explain the growth and the expansion of the church here within Canada?
Well, I wouldn't go so far as to say a pioneer, Sister Monica. I grew up in Canada, but I wouldn't say a pioneer. You know, I want to take that from the many brethren who truly are the pioneers and who were here actually since 1973 here, particularly in Canada, because as the church celebrates its 50th year in the West. Since it began its mission in the Western Hemisphere, starting in Eva, Honolulu, Hawaii in 1968. Included with that is actually the 45th year of the church in this year, 2018, because it was in 1973 when the Iglesia Ni Cristo, the Church of Christ, began here in Canada. And actually, we have something special, and if it's all right, if I could read this for everyone, okay? It was published in one of the local newspapers here in Canada, okay? It's a very special message from the Prime Minister of Canada, okay? I'm going to read it for everyone. It goes like this. So, July 27, 2018, dear friends, I am pleased to extend my warmest greetings to everyone celebrating the 45th anniversary of the Iglesia Ni Cristo Church of Christ in Canada. For 45 years, the Iglesia Ni Cristo Church of Christ has brought together Canadians who are committed to upholding Christian ideals of faith and service. This occasion, which also marks the church's 50th anniversary in the Western Hemisphere and 104 years since it was founded, offers everyone a chance to reaffirm their deeply held spiritual beliefs and to reflect upon the events that have shaped your church's history. On behalf of the Government of Canada, I offer my best wishes for a memorable celebration. Sincerely signed, the Prime Minister of Canada, Justin Trudeau. And that's it. That right there, okay? So the Prime Minister is correct. It's because, well, of course, the Iglesia Ni Cristo, the Church of Christ, attributes all success to the handiwork of the true God. But we also recognize the teamwork of the brethren, also with the community around us. Of course, also working hand-in-hand with the government to help people in many areas of life, through our reach out programs, especially helping people have to become model citizens in the country, in the area, and of course on the part of members of the Church of Christ to uphold their spiritual beliefs.
So it's no doubt that the success of the church has reached here in Canada and is truly expanding and growing greater and greater every day.
Right.
So now moving forward, what can we expect to see from the Church of Christ as it continues to expand here in Canada?
Well, being one that grew up here in Canada, because actually my dad is also a minister of the gospel in the Iglesia Ni Cristo of the Church of Christ. He was assigned here many years back. So I mostly grew up here in the Toronto area. And back then, there were only a handful of congregations, one here in Toronto, I think one in Montreal, one in Ottawa. But from, you know, those humble beginnings, the Iglesia Ni Cristo, the Church of Christ, has now expanded throughout Canada. We are composed of what are called ecclesiastical districts, so major regions of Canada. There are three now. We have on the western side and in the middle of Canada and here on the east coast. And it just has grown rapidly throughout the years, and it continues to expand. And of course, by the help and mercy of God, but also because of the great relation we have with the government of Canada, with the people, with the community, with you know, the local authorities, they are always there for us. In fact, one of the authorities was here earlier. I don't want to get his name wrong, so I'm not going to try to guess it. But he was here, and he said something wonderful during the opening remarks. And so we thank Canada for that. You know, we extend our thanks and gratitude also to Justin Trudeau for taking his time out of his busy schedule to write to us, and to the officials of Canada for their kindness. And we promise that we will continue to work hand in hand with them for the welfare of the people here in Canada, and of course for the glory of Trudeau.
Brother Falmar, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
And as we're reporting live from here, the CAA Center in Brampton, Ontario, as we continue to enjoy the celebration of the 104th anniversary of the church and 50 years in the West. Back